हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आहूजा क्लासेस स्मार्टनेस इन एजुकेशन। हियर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द लास्ट कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ रियल नंबर्स, दैट इज द रैशनल नंबर्स एंड देयर डेसिमल एक्सपांशन। लेट अस फर्स्ट सी व्हाट आर द रैशनल नंबर्स। एनी नंबर आर सपोज इज कॉल्ड रैशनल इफ इट कैन बी रिटन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पी बाय क्यू, वेयर पी and q are integers and where q is not equals to 0. Here let us see some examples of rational numbers as 0.375, 0.104, 0.3 bar, 0.53 bar, 14.285714 bar, etc. Bar refers to the repeating nature. So, a very important property obtained from rational numbers is that they are either of the terminating nature, like 0.375, or if they are of non-terminating nature, then they are repeating in a systematic manner. So, rational numbers are of repeating nature, but the numbers repeat in a systematic form, like 0.3 bar, 0.53 bar. So here 53 will repeat again and again. Here 285714 repeat again and again. So repeating nature is obtained when they are non-terminating in a systematic form. Otherwise, they are terminating numbers. So let us see two theorems based upon the concept of rational numbers. Let x be a rational number whose decimal expansion terminates. If the decimal expansion terminates and if it is a rational number, then it can be written in the form of p by q, where p and q are in coprime, and the prime factorization of q. The prime factorization of q is always of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m. So the denominator of the rational number will always be in the powers of 2, either 2 or 5, or 2 and 5 both, and no any other number except 2 and 5 will be present over there, where n and m are non-negative integers. Let us see the converse of this theorem. See some examples like 7 by 8. Here the 8 can be written as 2 to the power 3. That means we have, or we can write in the powers of both. So if I am writing in the powers of both, then we can write 2 to the power 3 into, we have multiplied numerator and denominator by 5 to the power 3. So we get 875 upon 10 to the power 3. So we have obtained that it is a terminating decimal expansion, and it will be solved. Then we will get 0.875. Here we have 3 by 80. That means 3 upon 2 to the power 4 into 5 to the power 1. So if I want to convert it into the powers of 10, that means I want to convert the denominator in the powers of 10, then I will have to multiply 5 to the power 3 in the numerator as well as in the denominator. So we will get 3 into 5 to the power 3, 2 to the power 4 into 5 to the power 4. That means 375 upon 10 to the power 4. So the result will be 0.0375. So this is also of the terminating nature. Since the powers are in the form of 2 or 5, or in the form or in the form of 2 and 5 both. Let us see one more theorem. Let x equals to p by q be a rational number such that the prime factorization of q is of the form 2 to the power n, 5 to the power n. If the decimal expansion, if the prime factorization of the denominator is of the form 2 to the power n, 5 to the power n, m, where n and m are non-negative integers, then we can write x has a decimal expansion which terminates. This is the converse of the above mentioned theorem, that if the denominator has powers of 2 or 5 or 2 and 5 both, then the term decimal expansion of the rational number will be terminating. Let us see one more theorem, that refers to non-terminating rational numbers. Let x equals to p by q be a rational number such that the prime factorization of q is not of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m only, where n and m are non-negative integers. That means the denominator has powers of other numbers except 2 and 5, or with 2 and 5. That means any other number will also be present in the expansion of the denominator, 3, 7, 9, any other number. Therefore, x has a decimal expansion which is non-terminating or repeating. So, if any other number except 2 or 5 is present in the denominator, then and with 2 and 5, then we can say that the decimal expansion of the rational number will be non-terminating. See here, for example, 1 by 6, the expansion of 6 can be written as 2 into 3. So here 3 is also present with 2. So due to presence of 3, the decimal expansion is non-terminating. Here 7 by 12, that means we can write 7 by 2 to the power 2 into 3. Here again 3 is present with 2. So again the decimal expansion is of non-terminating nature. Again here in the denominator 11 is present, which is a prime number. So again the decimal expansion will be non-terminating nature. Let us see a problem in which we have to, without actually performing the long division process, we have to determine whether the following rational numbers will have a terminating decimal expansion or a non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. Here the number is 17 by 8. It can be written as 17 upon 2 to the power 3, since denominator is in powers of 2 only, so that it will have terminating decimal expansion. Here we have 15 by 1600, and we can write 2 to the power 6 into 5 to the power 2. So this is again in powers of 2 and 5, powers of 2 and 5 only, so that decimal expansion of 15 upon 1600 is terminating. Let us see two more examples, 6 by 15 and 129 upon 2 to the power 2, 5 to the power 7 and 7 to the power 5. Here 6 upon, we can write 3 into 5. Here we will get 3 to the 6. So this is 2 by 5. Since the denominator has power of only 5. So this is power of 5 only. So that 6 by 15 is, or we can write 6 by 15 has terminating decimal expansion. Terminating decimal expansion. Let us see one more problem, that is 129. Here actually powers are directly given to us. So here with 2 and 5, 7 is also present. So due to 7, the decimal expansion of the given number will be of non-terminating nature. So we can write, due to presence of powers of 7 in the denominator, the decimal expansion of 129 upon 2 to the power 2, 5 to the power 7 to 7 to the power 5 will be of non-terminating in nature. So this was the basic complete concept of rational numbers and their decimal expansions. Thank you. For more educational videos, like, share and subscribe to Ahuja Classes on YouTube. Thank you.